Liberal losers freak out as Melania's secret plan for White House Christmas goes viral. President Donald Trump has made it perfectly clear that he is saying, Merry Christmas, and discarding the politically correct salutation Happy Holidays. Christians in America rejoice that the new commander-in-chief is speaking our language after years of the Obama's generic holiday parties and pagan decorations at the White House. Now, liberal losers who hate nativity scenes and speaking about Christ's birth are on edge after Melania's secret plan for Christmas at the White House goes viral. First Lady Melania Trump, like all first ladies before her, is in charge of the Christmas plans for the White House. That entails all the decorations, the official tree lighting ceremony, the pageantry, and entertainers for the festivities, and she decides on a theme, a tradition started by Jacqueline Kennedy. Michelle Obama's theme for her last Christmas in the White House was the gift of the holidays, which she defined as reflects on not only the joy of giving and receiving, but also the true gifts of life, such as service, friends and family, education, and good health, CBS reported. Michelle's holiday themes were antiseptic, devoid of warmth, which reflected the decor, described as pagan. Also, consider that it was the Obamas who broke the tradition of having a nativity scene in the White House, and Barack banned them from federal property in 2015. The key word not spoken, of course, was Christmas, as everything Michelle put out for the official White House Christmas season replaced the word Christmas with holiday. Now, Melania Trump just blew up the internet with a simple tweet, but it packed a huge punch straight at all the politically correct losers. This year's at White House Christmas booklet is in printing. Excited to receive the beautiful tree Monday. #ChristmasTraditions, Melania tweeted. Well, the big problem for the Christmas haters and those who abhor nativity scenes is her hashtag, #ChristmasTraditions. That hashtag was perfect and is setting the tone for what to expect from the White House this Christmas season, and it didn't make liberals very happy. In fact, their negative responses to #ChristmasTraditions were so profane, we won't post them here, it's pure evil. The vicious attacks over the First Lady planning a traditional Christmas were launched by those who hate Christianity in general. Christmas traditions harken to Christmas classic songs like Away in the Manger, or Silent Night, or the Ave Maria, which is one song that is said to bring tears to President Trump's eyes. Contrast a classic like Ave Maria's lyrics, which are the angel Gabriel's words to Mary, Blessed art thou among women and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus, to last year's entertainment, which Michelle orchestrated, headlined by Chance the Rapper. What a difference a year makes, as Melania welcomes wholesome ex. Nasty woman Ashley Judd must be having a fit that sister Winona has agreed to be one of the entertainers at this year's tree lighting ceremony. Others include the Beach Boys, Mannheim Steamroller, and the U.S. Navy Band. As far as the secret plan, what we know thus far, besides Melania's hint with her hashtag #ChristmasTraditions, is that a woman in North Dakota is beaming with pride after she got a letter from the First Lady which she never expected. Despite it being the most famous house in all of the United States, Watertowns, South Dakota, Candace Schumacher should feel right at home in the White House over the Thanksgiving weekend. Schumacher has been selected to decorate the White House for Christmas this year, making her first ever trip to Washington, D.C., one that she won't soon forget, reported the Aberdeen News. There was no application or anything. I just said I was interested in decorating the White House, Schumacher said. There was no response to her letters to the First Lady, and my kids kept telling me it was such a long shot. If you want to do something, you have to go for it or else it's just a wish. You don't want any regrets. You have to see what you can do in life. Finally, she got a letter from the First Lady telling her she would love to have her be in charge of the Christmas decorations. The Obamas had professional designers that cost taxpayers to do their blah holiday decorations, so we love that Melania is going with a regular middle-class mom from South Dakota who is volunteering her time. Schumacher has a great resume, decorating the Christmas trees at the South Dakota State Capitol, and is part of a team of 75 Americans who will help bring Melania's Christmas traditions theme to life. The First Lady's actual theme stays a secret until the big day the Christmas tree is lit at the White House on November 30th, but we can expect a very traditional look, including bringing back the nativity scene. Melania will not disappoint those of us who love America and who are so grateful for a president who vowed to bring Christ and Christmas back into the White House.